Hello everyone, welcome to Veranda IAS in the series of lectures of current affairs associated with art and culture. In this session today, we are going to study about the Warli painting, one of the important paintings for your static syllabus as well. Also, this painting was in news recently. The painting belongs to the state of Maharashtra. We'll discuss all the details about this painting and the local art form. The learning objectives of the day are to examine the Warli painting, to discuss why Warli painting was in news, to explain the meaning of the geometric shapes, and then to explain the rock shelter of Bhimbetka caves. Where do we have Bhimbetka caves? These are in the state of Madhya Pradesh. So why Warli painting and Bhimbetka caves we are reading? Because there is some or other similarity between the paintings found at the rock shelter of Bhimbetka and the designs of Warli painting. We'll try to understand and relate these two. Then we will list the uses of Warli painting. I'm sure all of you might have made some drawings in your childhood which includes mountains like this, sun and moon like this. What is it? These are these geometric shapes which are used in Warli paintings. Triangle which we used in our childhood days for making the drawing of mountains. The circle which we used for depicting sun or the moon. All these things are the geometric shapes. We were unaware of these at that time, but today we know it is a triangle. Today we know it is a circle. Warli painting uses these geometric shapes, uses these figures. How we will see, we'll show you the picture of the Warli painting as well. Then you will be able to understand the relation or the presence of geometric shapes in the Warli painting. Then we will discuss about the Warli tribe. The Warli tribe with whose name Warli paintings got their name. We'll start first and foremost, the Warli paintings belong to the state of Maharashtra. Important, very straightforward information it is, factual information, please remember. It belongs to the state of the Maharashtra, dated back to 10th century AD. Old art form it is, dated back to 10th century AD. The presence of geometric shapes make it unique, very important. There is presence of geometric shapes. How can you identify whether this painting is Warli painting or not? With this, like circles, rectangles, triangles, etc. There are some themes which we can see in the Warli paintings which are found in Maharashtra or in various other places as well. The themes mainly, not of Warli painting, but mainly the themes of all the paintings revolve around hunting, fishing, dancing or religious ceremonies and celebrations. Similarly, here we see that the scenes of hunting, one man behind a group of animal or a group of animal behind a man as well. Then fishing, farming, festival, dances are all the themes which are there in Warli paintings. Why all these are the themes? Because see, we studied this painting date back to 10th century AD. That time or before that or contemporary to that, what were the scenes which were very popular? Whatever a man sees, a person sees, that he imagines, that he draws. That was the time when people were seeing hunting scenes all around them. People were seeing there is good harvest, there is good crop. They were celebrating the festivals, they were burning the fire, bonfire was there. They were dancing all around the fire and various folk dances, folk musics were there. So whatever the man was seeing, the man was drawing. Similar is the case of the cave paintings. In art and culture syllabus, you might have studied about the ancient paintings which are found on the walls of the caves. When man was not knowing the art of writing, but man started drawing the figures, the blurred figures which he was seeing. During that time as well, the hunting scenes are very common, which we find today. See, this is Warli painting, one of the demonstrations, one of the Warli paintings, for you to understand in this painting what is dominant, the small geometrical shapes. This is some kind of celebration going on, where one person is beating the drum with the drumstick and other people are dancing. Some music and dance celebration is there. This is what is theme, and the use of geometric shapes also you saw. We'll move ahead. There is also presence of trees and animals in the paintings. The presence of trees and animals is also seen in the paintings. Why this topic was in news? It was the year 2020 November when Warli paintings were making to the headlines of all the newspapers. Why? Because Warli paintings recently were discovered. It was discovered that the Warli painting artist recently in Hyderabad were using this art style, were using this painting style to raise awareness about a variety of topics. Becomes more relevant. Why? One way it is folk art, and second way, what we are seeing, second side of the coin, it is used for awaring people on various social issues, variety of topics. So this becomes more important. In Hyderabad, it was seen that artists were using it for generating awareness amongst people. Also, apart from this, National Fertilizers Limited, this is a PSU, public sector undertaking, which is under Department of Fertilizers. National Fertilizers Limited used Warli paintings on their building. National Fertilizers Limited corporate office is there in Noida, Uttar Pradesh. In its Noida corporate office, it started hanging Warli paintings at the outside walls and started getting it printed on the walls as well. Why? To encourage this Indian folk art. To encourage this Indian folk art. So since it got to a government building, a PSU building, it again became a topic in the news. Something about Warli tribe. Where will be the resident of Warli tribe? Which place they will be the resident of? Obviously, the state of Maharashtra, because Warli painting belong to Maharashtra. So they are an indigenous group of people, or Adivasis we can say. Whom we say Adivasis? Primitive people, tribal people. We use this term for the tribes who live in the Maharashtra-Gujarat border region and nearby areas. So these days we see the movement of the tribes originally from Maharashtra, but found in the area of Maharashtra, Gujarat and the bordering states, nearby territories. They speak an unwritten Warli language. Warli tribe make Warli painting, speak Warli language. Can be spelled as this or can be spelled as this as well. Important is, this is unwritten language. This language is not having any script. This is only spoken language. That is part of the Indo-Aryan language families, southern zone. Language classification is there in that in Indo-Aryan language family, it belongs to the southern zone. Warli language comes under the group of languages of Indo-Aryan language family. Then comes the meaning of the geometric shapes. What these geometric shapes resemble to? Just have a look on this painting. What can you depict? What is the theme of this painting? Is it hunting? No, it is not. It is harvesting and some sort of celebration related to harvesting. You can see coconut tree. You can see birds. The presence of birds and animals we talked. You can see animals, birds. There is crop, people in the circle are dancing, there are huts. It is some type of gathering where people have gathered to celebrate some event, and probably that event is related to good harvest. That celebration is related to good harvest, because we can see crops as well. We can see people collecting crops as well. These geometric forms serve as a visual representation of the natural components found in our surroundings. These geometric forms are used to depict, and also they have a sense to depict the visual representation of the natural components which are found in our surroundings. For example, we have circles. Circle tell you what? Circle tell you whether it is a sun or a moon. Depicts sun or moon. Triangles depict mountains. Squares depict the major theme. Squares depict the major theme of the painting. Humans and animals are shown as two inverted triangles. We have seen in our previous paintings, you saw that there were inverted triangles depiction for any human. Like this, there is triangle which is depicting any human, inverted triangle, with the upper triangle representing the torso and the lower triangle representing the pelvis. So human figure is also depicted with the help of geometric shapes in this painting. Now, if you can relate it with something, then it's great. If not, then we will understand, where have we seen these geometric shapes before? You have covered your static syllabus of art and culture of ancient Indian history. Where have we seen the prominence of geometric shapes? It was in the Bhimbetka cave paintings, the rock shelter of Bhimbetka cave paintings. Very important. Interlinking of the topics is important in your examination. Bhimbetka caves are in Madhya Pradesh. Raisen district of Madhya Pradesh is home to the Bhimbetka caves, the foothills of the Vindhyan mountains on the southern edge of the central Indian plateau are home to these rock shelters. Bhimbetka caves are at the foothill of the Vindhyan mountains. Important. The word Bhimbetka comes from the word Bhimbatka or Bhimbatka. What does it mean? Who was Bhim? Bhim is one of the Mahabharat's five Pandavas. Batka is the place to sit. Batka, the literal meaning of Batka or Batka is the place to sit. So Bhimbetka caves got their name from this. Named after Bhim, one of the Mahabharat's five Pandavas, Bhimbetka literally means Bhim's sitting area, the sitting area of Bhim, where the Bhim used to sit. See, this is one of the pictures from the Bhimbetka caves. What can you see in this? You can see some hunting scene. You can see the use of triangles to depict human figures. You can see the use of geometric shapes again and again in this as well. That is why I have taken this Bhimbetka cave discussion here in this session. This was the time when people were not knowing the art of writing, but people knew how to draw. Why? Because they imagined. They imagined the scenes which they saw all around them. On the walls of the caves, we can find these paintings. Next is the use of Warli paintings. You can write in your mains answer writing. Warli paintings are used to embellish purses, bed linens, and a variety of other goods. These are used and these should be promoted as well. If these will be promoted in the bed linens, in the purses, in the watch straps, and in a multiple cosmetic things, that means these paintings will be able to reach more number of households. These can be popularized by this way, and this way we can preserve the folk art as well. Also, we can encourage the folk artists as well. It is a vibrant depiction of daily and social activities that the Warli tribe of Maharashtra uses to decorate the walls of their village huts with Warli paintings. In the far villages, distant villages of Maharashtra, you can find Warli paintings on the houses, the kacha houses, the huts of the local village people as well. So this was all for today about Warli painting, about why Warli painting was in news, the meaning of the geometric shapes used in Warli paintings, the rock shelter of Bhimbetka, and then uses of Warli paintings. Then we discussed about Warli tribe as well. So this was all for today. We will continue our discussion from here. Till then, stay tuned, keep studying. Thank you so much.